Alright, so we're back with another retro rebuild. I said I wanted to do this over the weekend, but I didn't realize that simming a full season on MVP Baseball 2005 was going to take me 30 minutes. Normally on MLB The Show, it takes me about an hour and a half to do a full rebuild, so it would have taken me an hour and a half just to sim through the seasons on MVP Baseball 2005. So I wanted to have some time, actually sit down. I even did a couple test runs over the weekend so that I could kind of get an idea of how Dynasty Mode works on MVP Baseball 2005, since it has been a while since I've played the game. So there's two major modes on this. There's Dynasty Mode, which is really comparable to what we have in franchise nowadays. And there's also an Owner Mode where you can create your own stadium, build it up from basically a minor league park to like a full-blown MLB stadium, like lights upgrade, concessions, like a team store, stuff like that. It literally is the Owner Mode. You're literally like controlling everything. It's really in depth, especially for an older baseball game. So we're gonna focus on Dynasty Mode just because that's like really comparable to what we have in MLB The Show, and that's the easiest way to do a rebuild. So I hope you guys enjoy these videos. If you want to see another retro rebuild, let's aim for 500 likes on this one, and I'll go out buy another MLB game, and then we'll just do another retro rebuild. So if you guys want to see another one, 500 likes. I'm shooting a little bit higher this time. Let's see if you guys can hit it. If you enjoyed the video, thumbs up down below. Subscribe to the channel if you're new and enjoy the content. And as always, let me know in the comment section which game we should rebuild next. So as you guys can see, we're doing a three-year rebuild. It's 120 years we could do if we really wanted to, and we just have a three-year stretch, and we can either get rehired or we'll get fired. So that's really how it works. I'm gonna leave everything as is. Injuries on. Actually, I'll turn injuries off. I'll leave them on, who cares. Suspensions are on. Yeah, players could get suspended in this game, which I thought was really cool. Rained out games. And I did say I did a like a test run. Let me tell you, trades are really hard to do in this game. Like very, very hard. So we're gonna play as the San Francisco Giants because I wanna use Barry Bonds. And I say that like kind of Barry Bonds because it's not Barry Bonds, it's actually John Dowd. And let's take a look at it really quick. So in the depth chart, you guys will see John Dowd. You know, that's the Barry Bonds of the old MLB games. You guys can see his attributes, his fielding stats, his like batting chart. They used to have that. They even had a scouting report for all the players in the game, and they would give you a quick scouting report, which I thought was really cool. The current contract. And then we're gonna have Marquise Grissom in center field, Moises Alou in right, Ray Durham, Omar Vizquel at short. We got Edgar Alfonso at third, JT Snow and Pedro Feliz at first, and then Matheny and Torrey Alba behind the dish. Starting pitchers, you guys can see who we have here. Definitely want to get a little bit younger with the first three, but we'll see what we're able to do. And then when you look at relief pitching, this is what we're working with. So again, kind of older in the bullpen. Definitely want to try to get a little bit younger. So we'll see what we can do. You guys can see the little red bar is their overall rating. So that's what we're working with. So the bullpen is definitely our weakest spot in the lineup. Definitely need to improve that. So we'll take a look at our batting order. This is that. You've already seen the pitching rotation. You guys have seen who we're working with. There's still players in their prime like Carlos Beltran, Carl Crawford. We got Manny Ramirez, David Ortiz, Derek Jeter, A-Rod. There are top players still in this game. But for the first season, I just want to let it go. I want to see how the team does. See who we could trade for next season. See who we can get in free agency. I want to see how the team is first off. Just let it, you know, play out, and I'll see you guys at the end of the first season, see how we do. All right, so first season's over. Let's take a look, see how things went. So we got like an inbox. They give you inbox things, emails essentially. So you have like Cy Young updates. You get like your someone's injured. Should we send somebody down because they're not doing well? Someone's unhappy because there's a morale system in this game. So you get a bunch of different emails throughout the season, basically filling you in on things like that. Team goals. Obviously, you have team goals that you gotta accomplish throughout the season. But let's take a look at the standings and see how things went. We won the division going 162. So it's looking like we're in a good spot. Don't really need to change the team too much. And things are looking pretty solid. So stats, not what I was looking for. I'm looking for awards, season awards. There we go. So MVP, John Dowd, 49 home runs. Okay, 220 hits. Definitely will take that. Let's take a look at like some of the other awards that happened. So Edgar Renteria got the MVP. Barry Zito and Jake Peavy got Cy Young's. Rookie of the Year were those two guys. Relief Man of the Year was Eddie Guardado and Kolb. You got Silver Sluggers, Gold Gloves, and MVP for the All-Star Game. So there's that. We'll take a look at our team really quick just to kind of see how things went. Jason Schmidt, not that great. Might be a player I look to get rid of or remove or trade or somehow get someone a little bit better. Brett Tomko, on the other hand, was fantastic. Look at that season. How did he not win Cy Young? Interesting. Kirk Ruder was pretty solid as well. Jerome Williams was okay. The ERA is a little high, but you know what? I think we can work with that. And bullpen-wise, it's looking like we definitely need to improve the bullpen. This guy was in our farm system. It looks like the CPU brought him up, which the CPU can just auto-generate the lineup, and it'll do that, especially since there's injuries. Player morale and also suspensions. There's a lot of like rotating of the squad, so this is what we're kind of working through throughout the season, or like what we have to do. We have to like auto generate the lineup and stuff like that. So since there's a lot of variables, this is the team. This is how everything looked. John Dowd hit 371 this year. Like, I didn't even notice that when that first came up. 371, that's insane. 344 for Pedro Feliz, who played second base. Okay. Can he play second base? Oh, he's a utility guy, so that makes a little bit of sense. Didn't really remember that about him, but okay. Moises Alou, at the ripe age of 39, hit 300 with 36 home runs and 129 RBIs. JT Snow, pretty solid season. A player I was actually considering getting rid of at the age of 37. I mean, at the age of 37, he's still putting up crazy numbers like this. If this was MLB The Show, he'd be hitting like 198 with one home run, and he'd probably be in like single A by now. So Pedro Feliz did well. Marquise Grissom, I think he's 38. Yeah, so he's still putting up pretty solid numbers. Edgar Alfonso, pretty solid. And Mike Matheny, pretty solid season. I'm pretty happy with the way the team performed. Like, I feel like we don't really need to change too much with this squad, especially since we did pretty well. So let's take a look at team management again, because payroll, you guys can see there's like a budget, payroll, bank, and everything like that. So our bank, we have 16 million to work with. Our payroll is 102. That's what we're paying players, and then I'm covering it, but our budget is 118 million. Like, super simple. Like, it lays out how much we have to spend, how much we've spent, and like it makes it a pretty simple payroll system, like something that MLB The Show should have, something that's super simple. Season wrap up, we already looked at that. But yeah, let's just keep moving forward. Let's advance to the playoffs. So preparing for playoffs. So the MLB team made it, the single A team made it, but the triple A and double A team did not. And you know, you got scouting reports for your team, your probable lineups and everything like that. Okay, so like even stuff that like I feel like MLB doesn't really have, and even though it's like small things, it's a nice thing to see. So let's take a look at the playoff tree. Not statistics, playoff tree. So this is what we're working with. The team that I'm covering up is the Boston Red Sox, but here we are, here we go. We're taking on the Houston Astros, which they were in the NL at one point, so makes sense. Schedule, let's sim the day, see how this goes. We won, you guys can see the record that happened. So we just lost some guy, he's gonna be on the DL. We're gonna simulate this day again. Ray Durham is out for the rest of the year. That's our starting, or our backup second baseman, but it didn't matter. We won, so we're up 2-0 in the series. Can we end it here? We do, so we should be advancing. Piece of cake. So let's move up to the next day, see what happens. So far so good. So we should be taking on the Marlins. So okay, can I advance? Preparing next round's schedule. All right, here we go. So anything important? No, nothing there. We'll auto utilize that, and then we'll go to the schedule again. Taking on the Marlins. Let's sim up to the day. Can we continue this good postseason record? We do. Ooh, 11-3 victory. Love to see it. We lost that one. Ooh, that's unfortunate. 3-2. So not terrible, but you know what? I'm happy with the way we're going. As long as it doesn't go 4-2. Uh-oh. So if we lose this, we're done, right? No. We have to lose two more, right? My math might be wrong. So 2-2. Yes, we have to win two more. Here we go. Oh, we lost. This is the elimination game here. So let's advance to the next day. And I should probably know this. Advance. If can I like manage? That's what I want to do. I don't want to play it. I want to manage it. So let's manage it. Here we go. We're hopping into it. We're going to pitch the batter. Juan Pierre, Luis Castillo, Miguel Cabrera, a young Miguel Cabrera. They got Josh Beckett on the mound. Double for John Dowd. That's his name. Maglio Ordonez is on this team. I'm pretty sure he was a free agent when we started this. So that's not good. We're down 1-0. So I think the Marlins signed him. So here we go. Can we get a run back? No outs. Let's go. Sack bunt. Oh, he gets on anyways. There we go. We take the lead 2-1. 3-1. There we go. 3-1. Let's get some more runs. It's only the fifth. I don't feel comfortable. John Dowd gets on again. Sixth inning, 3-1 ball game. I'm watching the stamina, making sure everything's good to go. 3-2 ball game. 4-3. Oh no. Okay. Let's take him out. Let's sub the pitcher. Who's been doing well? Let's go to Fopert. All right, so we got out of it. Bottom seven. We're limited on our innings here, our at-bats, our chances to score. We couldn't score there. So let's see if Fopert can get us out of this. He does. Grissom. Alfonso gets on. Matheny. We're going to pinch hit. Who do we go to in this situation? Who's got the best contact? Torrealba. Let's go Davy Cruz. Let's go back and let's see if we can do this. Bases are loaded with two outs. We need to score here. Oh man. Let's go to Puffer. Hopefully he goes 1-2-3. And it all comes down to this. This is our season. John Dowd gets on. Moises Salou gets on. Pedro Feliz gets out. And Grissom ends the season there. That's unfortunate. But made the postseason, which is good. Like, we're actually in a good spot heading into I was gonna say, yeah, we're done. Let's go to the schedule. Let's just sim up to this, see what happens. So we got knocked out, but at least in season one, we made it to the postseason. We made it to the NLDS. And the playoffs are over. The Marlins are your World Series champions in 2005. So that's a bit of a bummer, but it's a good start. It's a good start. So I briefly remember the offseason. So let's see how we get into it. I know I did a test run, but I didn't really get too deep into the offseason. I just kind of wanted to do a one-year sim, see how it felt, how trades would be. And man, trades were, yikes, trades are tough. My budget was decreased based on our team's performance. That's not good. So let's take a look at retirements. Who retired? Roger Clemens, David Wells, Jamie Moyer, Rafael Palmeiro, Julio Franco. Okay. So not a lot of MLB players, but you know what? I could see there's a draft at the end of the season. I forgot about that. So you know what? Let's let the CPU handle the draft. We're going to let them. I'm going to have my faith in the CPU to do the draft because I want to focus on MLB talent right now. I don't think like that we're going to get too many good prospects anyways. That would really help us out. We'll take a look at the one that we got. So we're looking for the Giants. We got Budzinski. He's a pitcher. Stats don't look terrible, but... And then we got Santana, another pitcher. Okay. And then we got Crespo, another pitcher. Those stats look pretty solid. He's got a fork ball as well. We got Boyd, who doesn't look amazing. But again, he's a prospect, so we'll work on it. Sign rookies. What do we got here? So let's just give them what they're asking for. And then we'll just keep moving forward. So I'll get to the good stuff. I'll be back in a sec. All right, so here we are. We're looking at all of our players that need to be re-signed, and we got a few. Definitely a couple that like I'm hesitant to do. Like Schmidt, I'm not really sold on him. Tomko is really good. So he's looking for 4 years, 3.7, a spot start. You know what? If we can do like 3.5, he rejects it. All right, so let's bump it up to what he wants. He refuses to negotiate. All right, I guess we're bump. Either wait until he cools off or make him an offer he can't refuse. Are you serious? He's gonna be a starter. Grudgingly accepts. Wow. All right, so he's got some hostility towards me. Let's see if he'll take like a 1 year deal. He is 34, so I feel like, all right, I'm pissing everybody off. So Kirk Reuter, he wants 4 years. I mean, he was really good, and it seems like MVP baseball older players still perform pretty well. So you know what? I think we can rock with that. All right, he reluctantly accepts. JT Snow, he's looking for 2 years, everyday player. What are his stats like? I mean, he's still got some power and contact versus righties. You know what? I'm cool offering him that like low of a deal. Jerome Williams wasn't terrible. Probably going to be like our five anyways. I'm cool with that. Pedro Feliz was very good. So we're going to make him our first baseman. Marquise Grissom, he did very, very well. Like I'm looking at it, like his season, it was fantastic. But he's got really good power versus lefty, contact versus lefty, good contact versus righties as well. But I do want to get a little bit younger, see if we can get a better second, shorts, center fielder, second base, kind of the same thing. I'm probably going to offer most of these guys contracts, so we'll get into that. I'll do that off camera. Trade players, I don't really think I'm going to be able to trade any players. And then once we get into like contracts for like players that aren't on my team, then I'll get into it. But if I do anything crazy, I'll show you. If not, we're going to start season two. We're going to make some trades, sign some free agents. I'll see you guys at the start of season two. So I was looking through different trades, and I didn't expect this one to go through. I saw Nomar in double A. And I was like, you know what? We need a shortstop. Omar Vizquel's aging. Maybe we'll get him. So I traded Cooper, who was in double A. I threw in a triple A starting pitcher, I believe it was. Let me see if I can go find who it was. And then I threw in, who else did I throw in? That I didn't expect it to go through. That's why I didn't make the trade. Or I didn't. Oh, JT Snow. That's who I threw into that trade. I threw JT Snow into that trade. And then two pitchers who were in minor leagues. I don't get why that trade went through. Because look, I'll try to do another trade and see if that goes through too. Because I've been going through trades for like 20 minutes now, 30 minutes, and I couldn't get anything to go through. So I've been looking for relievers and stuff. So like, look, Alou has more trade value or a higher overall than Antonio Alfonseca. So let's see if we can make this trade happen. It gets rejected. So I don't know why the Garcia Paro trade went through. So I'm going to see if there's like any other players that look decent in like double A that could potentially be good pickups. Like this starting pitcher here, he's 24. Doesn't look that great, but I'm going to keep going through it, see if we can find anybody, because if that's the only way I'm going to get trades to work, that might be something I have to do. So yeah, let's try to get this guy, because I want to strengthen the bullpen a little bit. So let's see if they take this trade. It's been rejected, and I don't know what to do to make these trades work. Maybe you throw in this guy. Yeah, see, like I don't know why that one trade went through, but the other ones didn't. What about this guy? How does he look? He's only got two pitches. I'll take him though. If I can get rid of Moises Alou, get him off the books, save us some money. See, every trade's getting rejected. So I don't know why the Garcia Parra trade went through. So I just wanted to show you that one while we had it there. So yeah, that's the trade. I don't see Garcia Parra on the list anywhere in AAA. So if I make any other moves, I'll let you know. If not, let's hop into season two. All right, so here we go. These are the three that I targeted. Carl Crawford, Dontrell Willis, and Mark Teixeira. So our bank is looking a little low. We got just under $3 million to work with, but I am so psyched with the team that we've put together. I mean, look, the starting rotation looks better now. This guy actually was really good last year. I want to see what his stamina is. 44. So we definitely need to fill up the bullpen. Makes a little bit of sense. The first three in our rotation look really good. 4 and 5. Pretty happy with 2. I mean, they're not terrible. Looking at our lineup, Nomar Garciaparra hops into that shortstop spot. Teixeira is going to play first. Carl Crawford can play center. So this is kind of the team we're looking with. Pedro Feliz is going to be our DH. But, I mean, look at that team. That looks really solid. I'm liking, the team we put together. Teixeira obviously won't hit 2. But, yeah, I like this team a lot. This is a really good looking team. Let's take a look at Omar Vizquel. He hits righties better. So yeah, I'll get the lineup set up. This is what we're looking like though for season 2. If I make a trade, voice crack. If I do make a trade though, I'll show you guys. We'll just hit done. Are you sure you want to end free agent? All of a sudden offers will be okay. Yeah. All right. So finishing the off season, we're actually just gonna head straight into season 2. But like I was saying, if I do make any trades, I'll show you. But for right now, I'm finding it almost impossible to make a trade. I don't know how I got Garciaparra on the team. I was just looking for players because I wanted to get rid of some of the players that we did have. I wanted to find a spot to get Teixeira at first base. That's why I traded JT Snow. And then we brought in Carl Crawford to play center. And then if there are spring training started, but let's just take a look. Transactions, let's see who's still available in free agency, because I feel like we could use some pitching depth, right? Actually, no, I think we'll be set. Let's see what his stamina is. 44, 48, maybe just move him there and then kind of rock like that. I'd be happy with that. Batting order, these guys on the bench. This is at our team. Yeah, I like this team a lot. This is what I'm cool rocking with for the season. So yeah, I'm gonna rock this for season 2. I like the moves that we made. Like I said, trades are almost impossible. So I don't even know if I'm gonna be able to make a trade. So I would love to get Pujols or Jim Edmonds or Roy Holiday, Vernon Wells, who else? Vlad, Bartolo. I would love to get some of these players on there. Manny Ramirez, Big Poppy. I would love to get some of these players, but it is so hard to get people on a team from a trade. So I think I'm going to have to leave it here for season 2, and I'll see you guys at the end of it. All right, season 2 is over. Let's see what happened. So we had 90 wins. I accidentally skipped the summary, which is a bit unfortunate, but let's take a look, check the standings. We still won the division, 97-65. So pretty good season. We won by quite a bit. So the division as a whole is just pretty atrocious. You guys can see the wild card as well. We'll take a look at the playoff picture anyways. So there's that. We'll take a look at our team and then we'll take a look at let's take a look at the season awards really quick. See if we won anything. Edgar Renteria was the MVP once again, and Albert Pujols was the MVP for the National League, so not John Dowd. The thing with John Dowd was his stats dropped quite a bit once the season started. So at the beginning of every season, they have a player progression screen, which shows you if a player went up or down during the offseason. So John Dowd, I think, lost 20 power versus lefties and 10 versus righties, so he went down quite a bit. Cy Young went to Yoan Santana and then Oliver Perez. Rookie of the Year was Barnes, who actually looks pretty good. He's a top 100 prospect. His stats look pretty solid as well. And then for the National League, it was Kawasaki. Okay, pretty decent looking prospects as well. We got Folk and Mata as the relief man of the year. And so let's take a look at our team, see how things went, because one of our pitchers was doing it terribly, and that was Lowry, so he still did pretty terrible. I also think I sent somebody else down. I think I sent Correa down because he was doing atrocious in the bullpen. So I was like, you know what, let's just bring somebody else in. and hope they do better. So Dontrell Willis, the wins and losses aren't there, but that is a phenomenal season ERA wise. That's very good to see. You got Tomko, again, pretty solid season. Reuter, very good as well. Jerome Williams had a very good year compared to what he did last year. He had like a high 4 ERA last year. This time he brought it down to a high 3, but still respectable. And then Noah Lowry, just yikes. Almanza came in. I actually put him here, so I guess the CPU moved him. Hennessy, not the best. Valdez, pretty good. He's actually a top 100 prospect, or he was a top 100 prospect before the season started, so decent season. Ardzma, pretty good as well. Almanza, I brought him up instead of, I think it was Puffer, because Puffer was really struggling. He had like a 7 ERA at one point. So yeah, I was like, you know what, let's just send him down and hopefully he can get back on track. Fickick has a 2.3 ERA, great season. And then Benitez, pretty good. Gotta love it. That's like pretty good stats all around from the team. So batting order, let's take a look at our bench. We have Kruko, Rushton, Davy Cruz, Kuiper, and Matheny. So decent, not terrible. And then when you look at the actual lineup, I know Omar Vizquel was a shortstop. I edited him and made him a second baseman just so that he would fit in that second base spot. Had a pretty good season. At the age of 39, he still hit 305 with 42 RBIs and 6 home runs. Garcia Parra had a pretty decent year as well, 24 homers, 286. John Dowd was 306 with 41 home runs and 115 RBIs. So even though those power stats, those contact stats went down, he still had a great year. Teixeira, a pretty good year, 281 with 22 home runs. Moises Alou, what is he, 40? And he's still putting up those crazy numbers of 36 home runs and 123 RBIs. Carl Crawford, pretty decent year. Pedro Feliz hit 326. He's unhappy because he wants to be an everyday type player, so unfortunately we just can't offer that to him. Edgardo Alfonso, pretty good year as well, almost 300 average with 10 home runs. And then Yorvi Torrealba, pretty good year, 340 average. So it looks like overall wise, or average wise, a lot of players do pretty well. So let's take a look at statistics, because I want to see like batting stat leaders. Can I do for like everybody instead of just by team? I can't. League leaders, there we go. Let's take a look. So batting, let's sort by home runs. Pujols was the leader in home runs for the MLB. Then you had John Dowd, Sweeney, Carlos Lee, I believe this is. Yep. Todd Helton, Troy Gloss, Andrew Dunn. You got Big Poppy, Jason Bay, Beltre. Let's take a look at RBIs. Let's sort that. You had Pujols, Manny Ramirez is up there. Alfonso Soriano's on the Braves. Okay, so he got traded. Interesting. Morneau, Gary Sheffield. Let's take a look at doubles. Looks like Michael Young. Triples is going to be Shannon Stewart, I believe this is. And then you got Omar Vizquel, Carl Crawford, Varoa. And then that's that. So let's take a look at pitching. Let's see who had the most wins. Yoan Santana. Actually, let's take a look at MLB, as this takes a little bit to like catch up to what I'm asking it to do. So the wins with Santana, you get Clement, Paulette, Oliver Perez, Roy Halladay. Saves was Mata. Then you have Benitez, Folk, Billy Wagner, Gagne, Isringhaus, and a couple other players. So pretty good season. Interesting to see some names pop up there. So yeah, let's advance to the playoffs. Since we did make it, we won the division, like I mentioned. Single A and the MLB squad made it. And let's take a look. Who are we facing? The Phillies. All right, so let's go 2 days on this one. Let's see how this goes. And we're at 1-1 on this series, so we'll sim this one. Hopefully we win. We don't, so we're 2-1, and if we lose this one, the season is over. So let's go back, let's play today's game, let's manage it, and hopefully we don't lose. Jerome Williams is gonna be on the mound, and then we're gonna manage it. Hopefully all goes well. Bases are loaded. One run scored out of that. So Placido Polanco was up. You got David Bell, Bobby Abreu, Jim Thome. Jeez. So it's a tie ball game, which sucks. I mean, that's just not the way you want to start a game, especially after you get an early lead. But we're back up 4-2, 5-2, and things are looking pretty good. I like to see that. So 5-2. Here we go. That's not good. 5-3. Home run 5-4. Really? Is it going to be 5-5? It is. We're going to take him out. There's just no point in trying to keep him in. So 5-5. You know, if this is how the season ends, that's going to be super disappointing. Okay, Edgar Alfonso gives us the lead, 7-5, and it's gone, just like that. All right, Fikic, I need you to come in, close the door, that's good. Teixeira double, Alou, there's like sack bunt, but there's not like sack fly, but the run comes in, 8-7, we're going to sub in our closer, Benitez, and hopefully he does what we need him to do. Boom. Perfect. That's exactly what I needed. So here we go. One more game in this series. We still have one more to go. And yeah, I'm feeling good. I feel like we should win this one. This one definitely feels like a good win. Let's not go Lowry. Let's go Dontrell. Even though that means he's not going to be ready for game one of the next series. But I'd rather have our best foot forward. Bases were loaded and we get out of that jam. And then bases were loaded for us and we couldn't score. So that kind of sucks too. But let's see what we can do here. Bases loaded, two outs. And a grand slam for Carl Crawford. That's what I'm talking about. That's huge. They do score. They do get back in it with a three-run home run. Then our pitcher, the D-Train, goes deep. Makes it 5-4. Then you got Garcia Parra goes deep. Makes it 7-4. And then Carl Crawford goes deep again. It's 9-4. Gotta love it. All right, so Dontrell's probably gonna go, what, six innings maybe? The game's at 10-4. And all right, 10-6, Dontrell's done. So that's good. He went, what, six innings? I'll take that for sure. A sub pitcher, let's go Hennessy again. Hopefully he can just go like one, two, three. He doesn't. He makes the game interesting once again. Like, what? That's a single. There we go. Let's take him out. Bring in Fikic. Gets us out of that. Thank God. Then Carl Crawford goes deep for a third time in the game. Whew. He's feeling it today. And then let's go Benitez. And hopefully he shuts the door here. Yes. That's what I'm talking about. That's huge. So we're going to be taking on the Marlins again. And he was, that was the team that kind of beat us last time. So let's not do that. Let's go to this game, simulate it. Hopefully we get the win. 3-3. That's disappointing. We won that one 7-1. And when I said 3-3, I meant like because it showed on the season, 3-3 for the playoffs. So it's tied up on the series. Let's see what we can do. We're up 2-1. This would be huge if we get this win. We do one more. That's all we need. We take the L. So it all comes down to this game right here to go to the World Series. We have to win this. Dontrell's good to go. I might throw him in. Let's put Dontrell in. And let's take on Al Leiter and the Marlins. Juan Pierre is up. Get him out. They still have Magley Ordonez. Whew. And then Edgar Alfonso goes deep to start the game. That's huge. No run scores there. Couldn't score there. They tie it up. Can we get that run in? We couldn't lead off triple and we couldn't score. There we go. Yeah, that was huge. 4-1 thanks to Torry Alba. That's big. Can we get out of this little just close game? I want to open it up. I want to make it just like 10-1 and just absolutely end it right here. Dontrell, just give me like 7. Perfect. That was huge. We get 7 out of the D train. And let's go to our setup guy. We've been going to Fikic and he's been pretty good. So hopefully he keeps it in check. He does. Pedro Feliz goes deep, makes it 5-4. We'll pinch hit. Yeah, why not? Let's see who we got. We got Vizquel. Bring in Vizquel. And he's going to get on base. He doesn't, which is fine. We're going to bring in Benitez to close the door. There we go. That was big. Dontrell Willis is 3-0 in the postseason, and we're taking on the Oakland Athletics in the World Series. Can we do it? Let's see. Game one, we win 10-6. That's big. All right. Game two, 6-1. Game three, I think we won again. Oh, we lost. All right. So 2-1. We lost again. 2-2. We lost again. Uh-oh. So, yikes. It comes down to this game. Dontrell. Do we go Dontrell again? He's feeling it. We got to give him the ball while he's feeling it. They have Dan Heron on the mound. Let's see what we can do here. They have Mark Kotze, Durazo. Let's see if we can get a run here. Maybe. Nope. Eric Chavez. Marco Scudero goes deep and it's 3-0. Okay. Omar Vizquel going deep makes it a 3-2 ball game. We're back in it. We need to score like soon. That's the thing. We can't score soon. We're going to be in some trouble. And who was it? John Dowd goes deep. Yes. That was big. Bases loaded. Come on. Ooh. Opening up the game right there would have been big. That would have been perfect. That would have been a great way to go into the sixth. As I say that, Garcia Parra goes deep with a 3-run bomb. Dontrell's still feeling it. Only 3 runs allowed. We'll keep him going. I think that probably will be the last of it, though. Yeah. Let's take him out. I didn't see who was up, but Ardsma's feeling good. We'll get the out there. And then going into the eighth, we'll bring in Fickick, I think, because he's been really good in the postseason. There we go. We get the out. No runs scored. Can we bring in another? We do. Vizquel brought in one more. John Dowd brings in another. We'll bring in our... Actually, let's just go back. Let's just have Fickett close it out. Game 7, World Series. Here we come. That's big. Holy cow. That is huge. So, Game 7. Do we go Dontrell again? No, I'm just kidding. I wish I could see how people are doing. I think we got to go Roeder. Ooh, Jerome Williams is feeling good too. Let's go Jerome Williams. And then let's see how this goes. Jerome Williams, Rich Harden. This is going to be a good matchup. I like it. Teixeira, 3-run bomb. Then Carl Crawford goes deep again. That's big. All right. No runs here. Come on, get out of this. Marco Scudero is being a pain this series. We do get one more. That was enough. That's a good insurance run. Get that run back that we allowed. And Crosby goes deep. But that's all right. We still got that 3-run lead. We should get it back here. Teixeira couldn't score the run. All right, 5-2. They brought in a reliever. And I feel like maybe one more out of Williams. All right, we'll take him out. Let's go... Ardsma, he gets the out. Perfect. Seventh inning. Can Ardsma give us one more? Yes. That was big. There we go. Can we get this run in? 6-3. One more. 7-3. 8-3. I'll take it for sure. Come on, Ardsma. Keep it up. He's feeling good. And it's looking like we're bringing home the World Series to San Francisco. We're going to bring in Benitez. And he's going to shut the door. And there it is. 8-3. We are the champions. Boom. World Series in 2006. I mean, I thought this was actually going to be a little bit tougher. The World Series MVP was Mark Teixeira. 4 home runs. I mean, that's a pretty solid World Series. 15 RBIs as well. So, they're extremely pleased, obviously, since we won. Let's take a look at the playoff MVP or playoff awards. Oh, that's it. Just the World Series MVP. And that's it. Yep. All right. Whichever. Whatever. We'll take a look. Let's see if this shows our like stats that we had for the postseason. So Dontrell had a 5 ERA, but he still went 4-1. Tomko struggled. Roeder pitched phenomenally. Jerome Williams as well. Lowry kind of struggled. Hennessy did as well. Valdez did. Ardsma, fantastic. Almanza, fantastic. And he started out the season in AAA, so he was a great addition to the squad later on in the year. Fickick was solid, and Benitez really good. So very happy with our pitching core. And then we'll take a look at the batting lineup. No. Ooh, I was fighting that one so much. But Vizquel did well, 283, 312 for Garcia Parra. John Dowd hit 348, 352 for Teixeira. Alou hit 309, 300 for Carl Crawford. There was a game where he hit three home runs, so he was an MVP for sure. Pedro Feliz did well. He had six home runs. Alfonso did well, and Tori Alba was a beast. Like, everybody did really, really well, and I'm really happy with the way this rebuild went. So I'm gonna cut it here. It's two seasons, because we did win the World Series, and also these seasons take forever, and I feel like I don't really need to change the team that much since we just won the World Series and we're already one of the best teams in baseball. So I hope you guys did enjoy this MVP 2005 rebuild with the San Francisco Giants and Barry Bonds. If you did, thumbs up down below. Let's get 500 likes on this video, and I'll do another retro rebuild in the next couple days. And that's really about it, guys. If you enjoyed it, thumbs up down below. Subscribe to the channel if you're new and enjoy the content. And in the comment section, let me know your favorite MLB game, and I'll try to pick it up for the next retro rebuild. Other than that, guys, I hope you did enjoy it. I'm going to leave two videos on screen now. My most recent one, and also one that YouTube recommends you check out. If you guys, you know, haven't seen them, go and watch them. Also, social media links are all down in the description, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. And that's about it, guys. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace.